This is where they talking about fat. Look at, man, motherfucker, I ain't sucking it in. This is what they call me, fat boy. This is why they call me fat on social media. Okay, let me suck it in now. That's me sucking in. See the difference? No sucking in. Sucking in. It's me pushing it up. Sucking in. See that shit on Instagram when it moves like, when that shit don't work.
The first boxing gym I ever started going to was right down the block. About 5-10 minute walk. It's Gleason's gym. And I walked in there when I was like about 15 years old. They had some amateur kickboxing fights there. I was doing kickboxing at the time. And me and one of my best friends, you know, Terrence, we had gone to a fight in the gym. And my coach put me in suspension. So I'm like, man, I'm not going to sit home and not do nothing. So I said, shit, I'm going to jump on the train and go to Gleason's. So, you know, my first day we're training Gleason's, a bunch of guys looking at me. This kid got some moves. He looks tough. So one guy named Martin, he's like, yo, listen, talk to my trainer, man. I think you'd be good fit, which is Harry Kite, who's now the godfather of my son. He was like, yo, yeah, come train, you know. And I think my step-pops and moms paid for like the first 2 months in the gym. After that, he never really charged me again until I became pro years later, you know. So, I mean, when I tell you Brooklyn's like really like home, like, it's home. Hello? It's really a mental switch, you know what I mean? Like, it's like Pandora's box, you know? I learned from a kid, like, everything that bothered me, like, when I had nightmares and stuff like that, I put into a box. I'm like, just put it away. Like, don't think about it no more. It's gone. They can't hurt you. And the minute I need to call on that anger, like, that extra energy, that negative, like, that black power, like, when I need that negative energy to come out, like, I release it. Like, I go and I open, go to Pandora's box, I open it, and I flip that switch on. And it's like, motherfucker, all hell let loose.
Big Baby ready to put in work.
What my man gotta do? What my man gotta do?
Oh, he getting a knockout. He getting a knockout, hands down. I don't think we going past what? What's the latest round we gonna see this dude in, Jay?
Huh?
What's the latest round we think we gonna see this dude?
Man, he said he gonna bring the fight to me, man.
So oh, really?
If he do that, we gonna get him out of four.
He's stupid.
But if he run like he usually do, I give him six.
Which he usually does. He like to dance. What's this?
It's some regular shit that Mike brought up.
I like it.
Mike got one for you too, but this is what you gotta wear tonight.
Yeah, that's cool.
You gotta wear something not so tight, motherfucker.
Look at this shirt this thing got me wearing, son. What kind of shirt is this, yo?
Shoot it at 120 for slow motion.
This shit is... This is a baby extra large. Come on, man. You gotta give me like a double X or something.
Yo, my next fight, I'm having like 4 or 5 of my bodybuilding boys come
that's
out.
That's a schmedium.
So that's gonna be hilarious. I'm gonna have all the niggas wearing tight shit. It's gonna look so funny. I'll be the only big nigga in somebody's closet.
Look at this shit.
You gave me the
studio. Look at this shit. What is this?
What?
You want me to be on TV
what?
Like this?
You're going out just like that. This is different. I'm not body made like that, motherfucker.
But I'm good on you.
Look, I make it look all right.
You know what? It actually do.
Look
at it. I'm about to go to work.
Chain snatching, ain't habit, gotta get it. Same from Brownsville to Rain British. Fatherless child, mama put double shifts, so the number runners was the only one to hang with it. Before you know it, I'm in the game, bang fit it. Fit no orangutans, pitil kid apps like oranges is, I'm dangerous. See, tell me what the name of this.
I'm home, baby. Look, I come out in some chancletas and a friggin' in some shorts.
All right.
three things are going to happen before you step into the ring. You're going to have to see a doctor, submit urine, and the ref is going to go over your rules.
Okay.
So get frustrated whenever you're ready to let me know.
No problem. And then this quest.
Protein shake and energy drink. Let's see how this goes. Luckily, my man back there is Trinidadian, so he speaks my language.
Is there a vending machine or anything like that? With
like go past one? The loading dock and then to the left.
To the left, all right. Vending machine? Yeah.
Vending machine is this way.
Straight out.
To be a Big Daddy's team, you have to lift.
What's up,
baby?
Nah, I'm good.
How you looking at? You're fighting an undercard or the undercard?
I'm trying. Yo, hey.
You ready for tonight? Ready?
Yeah, oh, we ready. We always ready.
So you better put this fight.
Showtime. There's nothing there. Come on. Quest continues. Perfect. Yes, my dude. Oh, my duckies. Following directions. I did the following directions. All right, that's one. Check.
Keep myself together. I'm sorry.
No, you good. That's going to be it, I guess. Let's see. Yep. Team Big Baby.
What's your name?
I'm going to box some more. Come on.
You're not Big Baby.
No, do I look like a Big Baby?
Big Baby's the guy from Over Bedside.
Yes.
Bedside,
the one that I'm
Marcus Garvey.
The one that's
been out all day. Yes.
That's
mm-hmm.
the one. Yo. And no protein bars, no protein shakes. Because that's how you eat that. I already got you one, but you want another one.
Looking forward to your fight tonight.
Likewise, appreciate it.
Good. Keep doing your thing.
Likewise.
Mention this after the fight.
We'll get there. Anthony Joshua's promoter. Bloody scallywags. Bust both of them up.
So we got urine, doctor, and the ref has to come and talk to us.
Mm. Watch your low blows. I want to see your belly button when you come in. I don't want to see a chest protector. All right? I want to see a groin protector. So that means your belly button, you have your trim there, and below it, that'll be low. Should you get hit with an accidental low blow, you have 5 minutes to continue. No holding behind the head. You know, if the clinch goes into a hold, and I'll be talking to you. You know, inside, I'll talk. Come on, blah, 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 blah. If you don't listen to me, I will break it. Take a clean step back and protect yourself. If you want to stop the fight, shouldn't have it, but in the event that you want to stop the fight, what you do is you can't throw a towel. You step on the apron, you let the inspector know that I want the bout stopped. He'll inform me, and the bout will be stopped. That's the procedures on how to stop a bout. Champ, you have any questions for me?
If I knock him dead, just call the ambulance quick enough.
God bless you. Good luck.
Yes, sir. Thanks
all right. Good luck, guys.
Fellas, I'm ready to get up and do my thing.
Go ahead.
I want to get into it, man, you know.
Go ahead.
Like a sex machine, man.
Yeah.
Moving, doing it, you know.
Yeah.
Can I count it off?
Go ahead.
One, two, three, four. Get up.
Get on up.
Get up.
Get on up.
Stay on the scene.
Get on up.
Like a sex machine.
They said some people were just meant to be police officers. Some people meant to be garbage men. I was meant to fuck people up. Some are football players. Some play hockey. I don't play boxing. I fuck people up. Punish him. I was bullfish. I ain't play football, I ain't play soccer. I was fucking people up. What the fuck, guys?
Let's go.
I
only fuck with my gang, 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 gang. I only ride with my gang, 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 gang. I only trust my gang, 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 gang. Get money with my gang, 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 gang. I only fuck with my gang, 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 gang. I only ride with my gang, 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 gang. I only trust my gang, 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 gang. Get money with my gang, 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 gang.
I only fuck with my gang, no. I ain't really cool with no rap niggas. And I ain't talking no Instagram. And I say, boy, I get at niggas. Whole life, wild shit. One gun case at the drug case. Never been on that foul shit like Stevie J. Hey, fuck Faye. Fuck niggas in this industry. One verse away from being enemies. One drink from putting hands on them. I cross niggas like the letter T. Don't treat me like I was no rapper. Niggas know I ain't no actor.
10 rounds of boxing scheduled in the heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He wears red with white trim. He weighed in at an even 248. His professional record, 18 victories, only one defeat. He has one draw and 12 big wins coming by way of knockout. From Vallejo, California, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the gentleman, Jarrell Washington. Washington. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner. He wears red with gold trim. He tipped the scales at a ready 298.8 pounds. He is undefeated in his campaign as a professional with a record of 18 victories. No defeats. He has one draw and 16 big wins coming by way of knockout. From Brooklyn, New York, the new Team Dynamite. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jarell Big Baby Miller.
And guys, I'll just say this. I have seen one-bedroom apartments in New York City smaller than Big Baby's upper body. He can use that jab.
And he's just fine with that jab. A good top right hand over the jab.
And let's not forget, Washington was even on the scorecards against Deontay Wilder when he got caught and knocked out. After four rounds, that was an even fight. He has to keep walking at him and apply pressure and hope that pressure, both in a physical and a mental sense, wears Washington down.
Right.
Well, clearly Washington's round, but bad sign. As the round mounted, he's been against the ropes more and more.
Yes. Yeah, and again, Miller's just able to do what he wants.
You know, guys, I'm big on facial expressions and body language and things of that sort, because I think they tell a deeper tale than what the fighters actually, what the fans actually see, because the language, the body language from both fighters, I'm really leaning more towards Big Baby, because Washington doesn't really seem to be, from his body presence, taking it well. Even though he had a great first round, the body presence and language from coming from a fighter, I understand that it's not a good thing.
Body, body, go! There you go! Keep pressing, side to side with that!
At this point, you know Washington's mindset is just, hey, every second I survive, I have a little bit better chance of Big Baby just getting tired of hitting me and tired of throwing punches, and maybe I get lucky. The problem with the strategy of taking a fight to the second half of the fight is, what if you don't get to the second half of the fight?
Exactly. On the other hand, I get the sense that Miller is pushing his punches a little bit more in this round.
Only recent heavyweight I can think of who weighed this kind of amount of pounds was Valua from Russia, who won a world title, and he was 7 feet tall.
Yeah.
There's that uppercut again, right hand over the top.
Nicely set up by Big Baby.
He has those sneaky shots. I mean, his hands are so fast, it's hard for Gerald Washington to see those uppercuts coming up. The referee just came in and stopped the fight, guys.
That's it, the fight is over, well stopped. Well stopped, and Big baby Jarrell Miller gets another win, remains undefeated, gets another knockout on his record as well.
Nas! Let's go! We came too far! Thank you, Lord! Thank you, God! We came too far, baby! Deontay, we're coming for you, baby! Let's go!
If you ever been in the bottom of projects, it's 100 degrees weather, there's no AC, man, it's just hard work. And it was good, it was fun. You know, my teammates pushed me, little B-Hop Africa, Earl, it was just fun, man. It was a very fun fight to fight in hometown. Like I said, I fought in front of 20,000, 30,000 fans already. The crowd, I didn't really hear the crowd, I heard the trainers. Just focus, get my breathing back. And you can see I tried to knock them out a little early, but it just wasn't there yet. I just took my time and had fun, and you know, just putting the pressure on pressure bus fight.
Shit, like I said, after 11 month layoff, I didn't take an easy opponent back. I just came back. I just trained really hard. And I wanted to have fun. I wanted a good opponent. And like I said before, you know when I get my timing, I drop my hands and have a little fun. It was there. It's just that I wasn't able to push on my back for as much because my quad tightened up. But like I said, I kept on going to have fun. With a round of applause. Listen, man, you're fucking worried, man. I respect that dude, man, because he's a warrior. A lot of guys don't go against Deontay and come back against an undefeated heavyweight, you know what I mean? And usually guys don't call me out. They never call me out. So when Gerard took the fight up, like, in the blink of eye, I said, holy shit, he really wanted to fight? I'm like, damn, I gotta get in shape for this.
He motivated me to push the last 2 weeks in the gym just to come out here. And, you know, this is for Brooklyn, man. This is for Brooklyn. It's not only for the Latinos, the Blacks, this is for the Polish fans, the Polska-Polskas. This is for the Italians, this is for the Irish. This is for Brooklyn, man.
Gerald lost, and he's a good dude. I don't want to say anything bad, but he was a warrior. He was a warrior in there. He tried his hardest. But Big Baby off 11 months was just too much. His personality is bigger than the ring, and his performance was even bigger. So the boxing world just gained a big star tonight, and I think within 3-4 fights, he'll be the biggest name in boxing.
Yeah, we picked it up. Now you know. Now you know.
I don't know if you know, but if you watch the replay, I guarantee it was those last three shots in that round.
I got suits and Jordan on.
Oh. I only mess with my gang, 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 gang.
Sometimes I'll be nervous once in a while, but I had fun.
You probably did,
though. I mean, I knew it was on a mission.
Though. It's not one of the best, but, you know, knock them down one step at a time. You know, good interview, you know, do it, and then we'll move on. We'll figure out who we got next. But then it's like, you know, you did what I thought you did.
I feel good, even if I'm MMA, guys, I got beat up on the floor. I'll do it, shit.
All right, we'll find you a heavyweight.
Yeah, find someone.
I'll ask for this guy, right? All
right, man. All right, congrats.
Get some rest, bro.
Thanks, all right,
man.
Bro. Yes, sir, appreciate it.
All right.
Thoughts on Broner versus Garcia?
That was a great fight. Your boy was just too tough. What's his name?
Garcia, boy. Big baby, god damn. Baby showed me some shit. I thought 300 pounds, but I guess you might be the best 300 pound that out there, for
tell
real.
Me, man.
Because you kept out, coming.
Tell you, boy, how
you kept coming.
And not only does he have the gift of gab, but he can fight.
Oh, he got the gift of gab. He won it. Before he was giving gab, before the fight, he won 2-0. He was 2-0.
Yeah, you know, it's coming, baby. It's coming.
He took the microphone from me and everything. Well, you bad man.
So was a star born in New York City?
Well, he beat him up like he's supposed to beat him up. Gerald fought back. The best fight he ever fought. Big baby stayed on his ass, did not get tired, and did not give up, not 1 inch, not 1 second. He just kept coming and kept whooping.
All right, where we going now? We're going out, baby.
Good. Thank you. I love you all. He did a phenomenal job. The man behind the camera, I loved him. He was amazing. And he made this night so pleasurable. Professional, kind, and he knows his stuff. Team Big Baby Miller.
Pizza and cornbread. Pizza and cornbread. Shut up, baby. Shut up, man. The way I like it, man, peace and quiet. Man, I can hang by myself all day if I have to, bro. Just don't need no big crowd, just chilling. You know what I mean? But I'm tired as hell, though. I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, we're on the movie, we're on the camera.
Hello.
We're with Team Big Baby. All right, we just going through the neighborhood. Me and the boys from the job. And where's the beat? Hey, the fifth. Right. Make sure you get a picture of the fifth beat on.
Get him.
Y'all get tired, that's gonna be my ass gonna get cooked.
I appreciate good work, you, man. Though, man. Yeah, that's what you gotta do, man. You can go a long way with
Wolves,
that, man.
Wolves. Yeah, thank you, brother. I see you, man.
All right, brother. Take care, man. God bless you, man.